And one more take on the impact of this shutdown, this time on science. William Brangham explores the ways research is feeling the heat.
There are thousands of researchers who are furloughed or working without pay at agencies like the EPA, the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, the U.S. Department of Agriculture, and the U.S. Geological Survey. And there are many others who don't work directly for the government, but who are also still feeling the pinch. People like the men and women at various universities who get federal money for their research. With the shutdown, the pipeline for that money is now blocked. With all these scientists idled, many argue that some very important work, things like the regular monitoring of chemicals to tracking of endangered species, is also not happening. Rush Holt is the CEO of the American Association for the Advancement of Science. He's also a former congressman from New Jersey, and he joins me now. Welcome to the
Good
News
to be
Hour.
With you, William. Thank you.
Can you give us a sense just of the scope and scale of the kinds of science that have been idled by the shutdown?
Sure. It's thousands and thousands of scientists who are missing their weekly paycheck, but they are also running into delays, disruptions, sometimes ruination of their research projects.
Ruination?
Well, suppose you have a time series and you have to get a sample every week, every month for it to work. Suppose you're doing field study and you're looking at stream creatures when the stream is at a certain level in January. Suppose you're preparing a space mission, a satellite science mission. You've got a certain launch window.
Right. I hadn't even thought about those kinds of impacts.
Suppose you're looking at insects, and you have to look during the week in the year when they mate. You know, if the government's closed that week and you can't collect the data, that's a problem.
Such a remarkable array of work that we don't really think of as necessarily being government-funded work. I mentioned some of the agencies at the top. Are there other federal agencies or even those that are doing particular work that you know of that's come to a stop?
The National Science Foundation, of course, is all fields of science. The Census Bureau.
The Census Bureau.
Out of the Department of Commerce. There are many social scientists either that use those data or are employed to analyze those data. The weather forecasters are kept on the job, but the people who tweak the weather models are not. And as we see snowstorms predicted in the east here, we'll see whether these weather forecasters are as accurate as they might normally be.
Do you think that when we look back a year, two, 3 years from now, that there will be a demonstrable impact on the scientific community and scientific research in the U.S.?
It's going to be hard to measure, but I don't doubt it. It's very interconnected. But at a time when we are concerned in international comparisons about how the U.S. science effort stacks up, this is not a good time to slow down. You know, the Chinese just landed on the dark side of the moon, and we have researchers who think that they should be doing work to help national security and human welfare and safety and public health, the very things that are at stake here. They're waiting at home for the phone call to go back to work.
Rush Holt of the American Association for the Advancement of Science, thank you very much.
Thank you.